Myf Warhurst and Zan Rowe have to be two of the most loved people in broadcasting.
Hells yeah.
These radio queens have dominated the airwaves and now they're dominating the podcast world with their hit show Bang On. And over the coming months, Myf and Zan are banging on all around the country with their Bang Fam IRL. Welcome to the show, guys.
Banging.
Everyone's like, can I please get some subtitles? What the heck are you talking about?
Can you believe that Tom Tilly just said bang IRL?
I just want him to keep going.
I know.
And also, there's no double entendre here. It's not what you think it is.
Oh, I'll clear that up,
too. But tell us, what are you banging on about at the moment?
Well, like literally right now?
Yeah.
Oh, God, you've put me on the spot here. What am I banging on about at the moment?
Beyoncé.
Okay, we have been banging on about your outfits. You both look super hot.
Thank you.
But Beyoncé as well.
Yeah.
I know.
Thank you. Cowboy Carter has been on repeat in our household, hasn't it?
I'm trying not to touch it. They're amazing beads.
Yeah.
You're doing nothing for the euphemism chat, but
it's not the show you think it is. Yeah, Cowboy Carter has been amazing. We were just talking about, you know, straddling and mounting up in the break. Again, I'm not helping myself, am I? At all. At all.
What's your pick of the album?
Well, it's hard because there's so many songs and you go between all of them, but I love Daughter, I love Yaya, obviously. Mm-hmm. I love, what is it, Sweet Buckin', the one at the end, yeah. That is a sexy
Sweet
song.
Honey Buckin'.
Sweet Honey Buckin'. Honey Buckin', yeah. Also any song that has stars in it.
Oh, yeah.
Just love that.
It's good.
But it's fantastic.
The Miley collab, come on.
Yeah. Oh, the Miley collab is perfect. Everything's great in that record.
But how often do you see eye to eye?
Yeah.
Well,
quite regularly, actually, but we often disagree on minor points, and I think that's what makes it interesting between the two of us. We come from similar angles when we discuss popular culture and contemporary culture and what's happening in the world, but we often come from a very different perspective and... Yeah.
And we never plan what we're going to say beforehand.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
No pre-production really like meetings or anything. Really.
Oh. I think we work for the ABC. There's no production meetings beforehand.
Well, I remember when you first started, we worked together for years at Triple J and you'd go from the big radio studio where the brakes are really tight, you're playing it really cool, and then you'd disappear to this room up the other end of the office and just bang on literally for ages.
Yeah.
And I wasn't, you know, not confident it would take off, but now I'm seeing you...
You're saying you didn't believe in us, Tom. Oh, how wrong you were. Yeah. 7 years later, look at us now.
But these crowds, like the live show, and going from podcasting where it can be a bit isolating to walk into these massive rooms of people applauding, it must be amazing.
Wow.
Yeah, it's wild.
Been phenomenal.
It's absolutely wild, and we didn't really know, because when you do a podcast, it's quite different to radio. You don't get those texts coming through or the messages immediately. But when we realised we had such a huge audience, we thought, we've got to get out there and see everybody. And
What do you think it is, Myf?
Like, I think because podcasts are more relaxed, we're more relaxed, it's more of us, who we are as people.
Yeah.
But also it's really intimate. People choose when they want to listen to you. It's not it's not on the radio, it's not, you know, when you're in your car. You decide to listen to us and they feel like
it's
family.
It's very democratic,
it
isn't
yes,
it?
And
yes.
I feel like you guys, you are more honest and you don't have to be, like, cool like you're on radio, because Zan, you've talked a lot about your love of gardening on the podcast, which you wouldn't...
Gardening is not cool, Tom Tilly.
In fact, Gardening really? Australia is about to kick off, so for anybody who's a fan, you know what I'm talking about.
Gardening's cool, but I don't think in your, you know, earlier radio days you would have been banging on about the gardening.
No, you know what? This is a great freedom, I think, with getting a little bit older and what we like to call CBF energy. I think everyone knows what it is. Like, you do actually let a lot of things go, and that was one of the beautiful joys of doing the podcast, was that we really had to kind of unlearn those professional things that we kept a screen up. Mm-hmm. And for Bang On, we just sort of let it go and enjoyed each other's company. And, you know, lo and behold, everyone really loved that. And they're connected
to
that.
Do you think?
That's the community, because people want to feel like they're hanging out with mates, and that's what they feel like. And that's what we feel like at these shows. It's just like, it's such an incredible vibe in the room when the Bang Fam get together.
And what happens at the live shows that's like different from the pod?
Lots of sex. No. At the live shows. But we do a lot of audience participation by choice. I'm going the wrong road. But we do a fashion parade because we love talking about fashion. Myf in particular knows how to understand the most cooked fashion of every week.
There's great joy in fashion, as we call it. And I think the stuff that fashion houses give us and people will wear just astounds me week in, week out. And I love it because it's joyful in a way.
Sure.
So we've got audience members coming up if they want to model certain things that I've cobbled together to resemble.
Myf's been to Bunnings.
I've got a lot of gaffer tape and
the Sensory style. Yes. Kanye's wife's fashion.
All the entendres and everything in between happens on this tour. Bang on. It continues over the coming months. You can find all the info on our website. It's so fun. Would you please thank the Queen?
Thank you. I never doubted you.